Here in Hollywood, Devon Franklin isn't your typical film executive. This behind-the-scenes movie maker graces magazine covers. He's married to actress Megan Good, and he's a minister.
When you turn the page to the book of Joshua, God says Moses is dead, he's not coming back, but you guys have to get up, stop mourning, and go into the land that's promised to you.
You actually started preaching when you were 15. Some would say, what's a preacher doing in Hollywood?
And I would say, what's a preacher not doing in Hollywood? You know, I mean, you have to. The Bible consistently, God consistently puts his people in perceived difficult environments, perceived dark environments, and perceived challenging environments. Because what better way for him to get the glory than for his people to succeed in environments where people think it's not possible?
Succeeding against the odds is a familiar script.
Don't ever let somebody tell you you can't do something.
For the man who helped to make The Pursuit of Happiness, Heaven is for Real, and Annie.
He's gotta go.
Devon's story begins in San Francisco, where he and brothers Donald and David grew up, the children of hardworking childhood sweethearts.
My father took a job at UPS, you know, was making his way up the corporate ladder. And all the while, you know, we had what people would perceive as American dream. But then, of course, with any, you know, great story, conflict comes. And one of the greatest conflicts was my father was an alcoholic. And as part of trying to keep up socially with, you know, his peers and counterparts at UPS, he started drinking.
That derailed not only Dad's dreams, but Devon's childhood as well.
It went from, you know, a few nights not coming home, to weeks not coming home, to not being able to hold down the job, to losing the job, to losing the house, you know, to losing everything. And we had to, you know, move out of the home and move in with my grandparents, who had, they had to sleep in the motorhome at night because there wasn't enough room in the house.
The burden of holding the family together fell on his mom.
It was very traumatic, but even through all this, I never looked at him as less than a man, as less than my father. I just recognized that, you know, he was going through something and had a disease that, you know, was bigger than him. And my mother never spoke poorly about him.
Things appeared to be changing for the boys and their father when Devon turned 9.
He got his life back together. He got back in the church, and he had had a heart attack. He was in the hospital. He had gotten off alcohol. He had gotten off cigarettes, and we went to go visit him. And he was saying, hey, you know, when I get out of here, you know, I'm coming back. You know, we're going to get this family back together. And we were like, great. And then the very next day, we got that call, you know, right after school that he had had another massive heart attack in the hospital and they couldn't revive him. We go and, you know, we see him in the morgue. And, you know, my mom says, kiss your dad goodbye. You know, and so that moment of like, you can't quite process what's happening, because as a kid, you're like, where does God in all of this? And what am I supposed to think and feel?
He turned to the church and to movies for comfort from the pain, seeing films like The Color Purple, Rocky, and Back to the Future.
I think that that moment, that tragedy, really helped plant the seeds for me for what I do. You know, in a movies like Annie, where you see a young kid who's trying to find their way, you know, I deeply connect to stories like that because I understand it and I had to live it. And it really was, you know, as an adolescent, the church, entertainment, and school that really gave my outlets to help save my life.
Devon mapped out a plan to become a Hollywood film executive by age 30. It worked, as he became one of the youngest vice presidents at Sony Pictures and worked with some of the biggest names in the business.
In a unique way, your dad sort of inspired and motivated you.
You know, my dad at 36, I just turned 36 a few months ago. So, you know, being 36 and he passed away at 36, you know, it's, I want to be able to finish and do the things that he was not able to do. So I don't want to be at the end of my life and say, oh, you know, well, everything I couldn't do, it was worth it because those drinks were so good. No, I'd rather be at the end of my life and say, hey, I did everything I was supposed to do and I'm not gonna miss the drinks, you know, at all, right?
So your dad was an alcoholic. Your dad's dad was an alcoholic. Did you live in fear that that would be your fate?
I didn't live in fear. I just made the choice not to partake in alcohol. I think we sometimes diminish the power of choice that we have. God has given us the ability to literally choose the life that we want. And I believe that, you know, God has a great plan for all of our lives. And my part, you know, the Bible says faith without works is dead. So my part in the works are to make great choices. that allow me to receive the very optimal plan that God has for my life.
In the latest chapter of that walk, Devon travels the country, sharing his story and book, Produced by Faith. He's also moved on from his dream job at Sony to start his own production company, Franklin Entertainment.
So you got this new production company. What can we expect?
We are still seeing it evolve. We're seeing what God has in store. And every day is a walk of faith, because I don't know what he's going to do, but I'm open to what he is doing.
He's already landed a follow-up to the film Heaven Is For Real, a movie based on Christy Beam's soon-to-be-released book, Miracles from Heaven. Ephraim Grant, CBN News.